being the perceiver of thought. You are beyond thought. Being the perceiver of time. You are beyond time. Being the perceiver of identity. You are beyond identity. Being the perceiver of emotion. You are beyond emotion. Being the perceiver of mind. You're beyond mind. Being the perceiver of concepts. You're beyond concepts. Where is that location . Where is the location of that which perceives the sense of inside and outside simultaneously? The perceiver cannot be ultimately the object of perception. However, if there is emotional interest or attraction to the object of perception, then the perceiver shares the traces of the object of perception is inside the subject of perceiving. If this is so, what perceives these? Any movement of thought arising also is perceived. Silence is perceived. The vastness that is perceived by the mind is not the true self. The vastness in which the mind itself is perceived, that is the self. The pure self can never be an object of perception. Even the qualitative subject of perceiving is phenomenal to it. Leave these words to find their way. Beware. If there is any expectations, any waiting, you are not this. No, it is the mind. The pure self has nothing to wait for. Nothing to gain. Nothing to lose. Nothing to change. Nothing to keep. Nothing to become. Don't offer this to the mind. There's nothing to imagine, nothing to create, nothing to manipulate. Only to understand the presence and functioning of the seed of perception is itself manifested within the pure self. The very perceiving of consciousness is not an action of the self. The self is neither high nor low. It cannot be said to be located within or without. Being infinite, it is everywhere. Surely, it is within your own self. Amidst the apparent chaos in the world, is the inscrutable harmony of the self. Those who love God or have plunged deeply within the ocean of the self find this harmony and are timelessly happy. Let your mind live inside your heart. It should not be seen to be functioning independently. Mind has no autonomy. Like the moon is only the reflected light of the sun, they say, so the mind is only a reflected light from the heart. You are the heart self. To awaken to this knowledge experientially is freedom. To not truly know this amounts to some form of bondage. Any form of bondage cannot be eternal. Therefore, there are stages of maturity for the mind, which is the journeyer. There are no stages for the self. Are you inside or outside? Of what? Now I invite you to leave everything for a few moments. All that is conceived or perceived in the mind, leave aside. Cling to nothing, not even to the sense I. It is possible. Do not take any shape. Cling to no form, hold no aspiration, cling to no method, disassociate from every habit. Are you not still here? Who are you here? T- tell no one. Who are you here? Do not attempt to answer these questions outside. Confirm only inside your heart. Who or what? Tangible, intangible, matter, thought, spirit. Unknowable, are you a story, history, do not fall into sleep. Self is not asleep. It's even beyond phenomenal awaking. Imagination is not necessary. There's nothing to create. See only from the place of isness, the uncreated self. Look from your shapelessness. Be without becoming. Stay at the place which is already so. No need to imagine. Where have you come from? Did you come? Where can you go? Do not cling to shapes. All form are forms of time. You witness these. But that which observes, that which perceives, can it itself be perceived? And if so, by what? Don't give this to your mind. Inside these questions are the answers. None can give you yourself. They can only be a mirror. In which the timeless recognizes itself. What are you perceiving? Don't cling. Don't combine. Have the courage to be alone. Feel it beyond the mind's limitation. Perhaps you might come to see that you're alone as everything. If this is too much, then simply don't combine. When you don't cling to the world, what do you lack? See. When you experience this, then everything you can touch, nothing will defile you. There's a great sense, a movement of coming and going. Is it you? Or is what you perceive? Did this body ever say it is you? Or is it more that it is you who say you are the body? Necessary it is for perception and for experience. We are inside this body. But as consciousness, this body is inside you. As are all things that you perceive. But if it's not understood, don't force. Simply learn to perceive, but don't combine. Don't take shape so quickly. And your perceiving will be pure. What is your state now? Is it transferable? Is it an aggregate of sensations, your state? If even this comes and goes, be that which perceives this. You're far beyond what your mind conceives you to be. Or what you conceive yourself to be through the mind. If you should find that you are still fighting shadows in the mind, at least admit it is only phenomenal. It is only a play, momentary. Pull your seeing back into the source. Remain in the neutrality of being. But even if there is movement inside the mind, what is that to the self? Stay as the self. Now be in this space of silence. An uncreated space. Be inside the silence as silence itself. You need not take any shape. Actually, there's nothing to do, only to see and confirm. Be the emptiness inside the fullness. Be that stillness inside the storm. Be the invisible inside the visible. Be the nothing inside the everything. Be that which is beyond you and me, and this and that. Recognize that which is beyond form. Drown in the ocean of emptiness. This is your Guru Purnima day, and this is for you. Drink deeply from God's cup of emptiness. A language only your heart knows. Speak to no one about this. Marinate in yourself. Emptiness, walking in the form of a human being. But this emptiness is not a dry thing. Unimaginably intelligent. Whose fruit is peace and love and openness and wisdom and joy and life. Let your life speak instead of your mouth.